Well, each month we have been sharing with you stories highlighting the positive impact of Florida's immigrant communities in a series called Making It in America, Tales of Immigrant Triumph. In this week's installment, filmmaker Oscar Corral introduces us to a businessman from Nicaragua whose cement trucks you've probably seen out on the road. He's a well-known figure in the South Florida construction industry and plays a vital role by providing jobs while inspiring an entire community.
I came to the United States in 1979.
When my parents stayed behind, I came with my brothers from Nicaragua. So we're living in one bedroom, the mattresses on the floor, and we're all there. It is hard, but you come here with one goal. Your goal is to be able to survive. Your country is being ruled by a communist president, so you do whatever it takes to make it. And therefore, my frustration of not making enough money made me realize that in order for me to succeed, I have to basically have my own business.
This year, we honor someone who has built his company from the ground up. Let's give Luis Garcia, my friend, a big round of heartfelt applause as we honor you with the BASF Philanthropist of the Year Award.
Luis really is the embodiment of that immigrant community that's in this city. You know, this city in Sweetwater, we're a very working class community of immigrants who have come here from Nicaragua, from Cuba, Colombia, like myself, and I've started small in trades, in plumbing, in welding, in painting, and Lewis started over 30 years ago in construction with pumping, and now he's one of the largest suppliers for this area, for South Florida.
We are the largest family-owned concrete company locally owned in South Florida. So we're always growing. We have to grow to be able to stay competitive and be able to offer more to our clients.
He's always trying to envision, how can I make it better for my client so that I could be that one-stop shop and I can provide him that service. I mean, the clients that he has demand that productivity.
You are the company. The company is not Luis Garcia. La empresa es cada uno de ustedes. You are Adonel. You are the one responsible of the company's success.
Gracias a Dios, después de 32 años, vamos para 33 años, hemos tenido una empresa saludable, una empresa con un crecimiento increíble.
Antes que nada, quiero agradecer al señor Luis García de Yanira por la confianza que pusieron en mí.
I'm Manette, and I'm the controller.
Seeing him and what he has built and his passion for this company and his passion for the community, his passion for his employees is what makes people motivated to work for this company and want to do good for the company.
Relationship is important to have, but you gotta deliver. You gotta deliver a good service. You gotta deliver a good product. You gotta deliver a good quality.
A lot of his trucks used to come deliver a product in our city. 50% of the concrete in Doral, I think, comes from Adonel and Lewis. So, and considering right now, Doral is the 10th fastest growing city in the country, I think that says a lot.
I came to this country basically broke, no money. Someone gave me $7,000 loan, and I had built a great company. My family worked for me. We have over 300 people working for us. We're an international company. We're in different counties in Florida. So I can say that I fulfill the American dream.
And joining me now is Luis Garcia, founder, president, and CEO of Adonel Concrete. Luis, great to have you with us.
Thank you. Thank you for the invitation.
Such a beautiful piece. Oscar did such a lovely job. What was your thought when he approached you and said, I want to feature your story?
Amazing. Amazing. Because in South Florida, there's many people that do great things, a lot of immigrants. And he says, Luis, I've seen you grow, and I think that you will make a great impact in our community. So I'm very honored. I'm honored for being here today.
So tell us, we saw your story, but tell us a little bit more about how you got started. I mean, so really, you didn't have enough change in your pocket and said, I have to do something, and you started with that first truck,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I came very young. I came when I was 15.
Yeah.
So I came with the intention that I was going to go to school, and I realized that going to school only, it was not going to be enough because I didn't have any income. My brother was supposed to support me because I was only 15, 16. but the money was not good enough. So I said, listen, I have to go to school and I have to work. So that's how everything started. And when I was working, I wasn't really making that much money in order for me to buy anything I want, like I had back in my country.
Right.
And I say, wait, hold on one second. So I started going to school at night and then working during the day for another company. And I say, you know what? I was frustrated. Mm. I needed to make a change in my life. I always look up to people, and I always look up to people that do better than me and myself. So there's few people that I say, you know what? These people have my age, they're 20, 21. They have their own business. If they can do it, why I cannot do it? Well, so that's how everything started.
Was anybody your mentor? Did you turn to anyone for advice?
No advice, it was in me, it was in me. I remember I started selling when I was 16, I was selling shoes by magazines. I don't remember, many years ago, you had some magazines and you show it to your friends and they will buy the shoes from you. We used to sell shirts, I used to sell used cars. This was all at 17, 18.
Wow.
So it wasn't me, I wanted to do business.
You had that entrepreneurial spirit inside of you.
Yes.
Yeah. So tell us now, I mean, these pieces that Oscar Corral has been doing is to highlight the immigrant community in Florida and really kind of show people what immigrants bring to the fabric of our society. So as an immigrant and seeing these, what is your take on how, in many aspects, immigrants lately have kind of taken heat? We're talking about building the wall, the Trump administration wants to continue to do that. And do you feel that people sort of lose sight of how immigrants really continue to impact our community?
Well, this is a conversation that is going to take a while. I mean, it's very a conversation that is not going to be resolved tomorrow. Mm. I was fortunate enough that when I came to this country 38 years ago, none of that was happening. Mm. Coming to America, it was the freedom country. Mm. And if you have problems in any of your countries and you want to be free, go to the United States. It's the place for the opportunities. You work, and you grow, and you do whatever you want. So it's unfortunate what happened right now, but it's a long conversation.
Yeah. Well, it was great to have you. Your story's really inspirational. We thank you so much for allowing us to hear it and for sharing it with us. So thanks for being here, Lewis.
Thank you for the invitation.
And we're going to continue to bring you more stories like Lewis's each month. And for previous videos from Oscar Corral's Making It in America, check out our Facebook page @YourSouthFL.